Go ahead.
Thank you, Jen. I was home all last week, isolating.
Welcome back.
Thank you. I was isolating with COVID after a positive test, like a lot of people watching, and a lot of time in front of the TV. I heard the president say...
Did you watch Fox the whole time? Or other things?
I have exhausted the full catalog of Guy Fieri content.
Oh, okay.
And obviously a lot of Fox. But I heard the president say, Google COVID test near me. So, somebody isolating with COVID, I did that. And the appointments everywhere were completely jammed. So, why is it that you guys were so unprepared for the need for testing after the holidays?
Well, Peter, I'm happy to see you back and well. I would second say that there has been a massive surge in cases, as you know, and we're a part of, in D.C. and New York. And there's been an unprecedented, and other parts of the country as well, there's been an unprecedented demand for tests. So what we have done over the course of the last few weeks, even before that, is the president quadrupled our testing capacity since the summer. We opened 20,000 sites across the country, and we have also opened additional federal sites, including one in D.C. only recently. He's also provided, we've also in the process of sending 50 million tests out to community health centers and rural health centers, and now we're in the process of finalizing contracts for 500 million tests. But can I make one more point, and then you can go next? I would just note where we have come from. If you look to a year ago, there were no tests, or maybe one, depending on the timeline, that was available on the market. Now we have 9. If you look to about a year ago, there was about 900,000 or maybe slightly higher tests that were being issued every day. Now we're about 10 or 11 million. 300 million tests are done in this country every month. So there's enormous progress being made, but we needed to make sure the market was growing. That's what we've been working on, and increase our access to supply. And that's what we've been doing.
The tests you're talking about, though, require people to go somewhere and either make an appointment or wait in line. The CDC's guidance is if you think you have COVID, you're supposed to stay home. You guys said you were going to mail free tests to people that need them. The president's there on television talking about a winter of severe illness and death. While he's saying that publicly, why weren't you guys doing more to prepare for the winter?
Well, Peter, everyone decides where they're going to go get a test. And we make a range of options available. You can also purchase tests online. Later today, we'll have more details on how 150 million Americans who have health insurance can get reimbursed for tests. So we'll have more details on that later. The 500 million tests I noted, and I give you a little bit of an update on the timeline. We'll have more on the website later this week. So our steps and our process from the beginning has been expanding access to free tests to make it easy and more accessible for Americans. And we're going to continue to build on what we've done to date.
But the president talked about a winter of severe illness and death. At the rate you guys are going, these tests are not going to be available until spring. So will you admit that these free tests you guys promised are not going to be ready until after the Omicron surge?
I think I gave an update earlier that we'll start to have tests out the door in the coming weeks very soon.
Okay.
And again, that's not the only place people can get tests. There are a range of ways people can get tests online. Again, you'll know more about how you can be reimbursed for those tests from here. Go to different sites. There are federal sites opening up all around the country.
And we understand that you guys plan to rely on the Postal Service to send out these free tests whenever they're ready. But the Postal Service says they're going to have a staffing shortage because of your vaccine mandate. So would you pull back on the vaccine mandate if it meant getting people these free tests sooner?
The Postal Service also delivered 98-99% of packages on time in advance of Christmas. And they also, their leaders have also said they're eager to take on this challenge. So we welcome that, and we're looking forward to working with them to get these tests out to the public.
And I understand that the science says that vaccines prevent death. But I'm triple vaxxed, still got COVID. You're triple vaxxed, still got COVID. Why is the president still referring to this as a pandemic of the unvaccinated?
Well, I think, Peter, there's a significant difference between, and you just experienced this, and not to expose your public health experience, but I can speak to mine as well. I had been triple vaxxed, I had minor symptoms. There is a huge difference between that and being unvaccinated. You are 17 times more likely to go to the hospital if you're not vaccinated, 20 times more likely to die. And those are significant, serious statistics. So yes, the impact for people who are unvaccinated is far more dire than those who are vaccinated.
Will the president update his language at some time to be more reflective of the fact that people who are triple vaccinated are catching and spreading COVID?
I think the president has said, as have we a number of times, that there will be breakthrough cases. There will be people who get COVID here at different media organizations, at companies around the world, around the country, who have been vaccinated. But there is a significant difference between being hospitalized or dying and being vaccinated with more mild symptoms.
And then last one, you guys have been very aggressive countering COVID misinformation. So what do you guys think about COVID misinformation coming from the Supreme Court and Sonia Sotomayor's false claim that over 100,000 children are in serious condition, many on ventilators?
Well, I'm not going to speak to Supreme Court arguments or statements made in those arguments, but I will tell you that what is at stake here is our effort to protect health workers and, most importantly, protect patients with the CMS rule, and also to make workplaces safer with the OSHA rule, which we have confidence in our legal argument for. So I will leave it to them to decide, but that's what's being argued now. Go ahead.